Hello and welcome! In this video we are going to talk a bit about Laurent series. We will start with a theorem and then we will continue by determining all possible Laurent series for each function here below. So let's get going. The theorem tells us that if a function is analytic on some Annulus domain, then we know that the function is going to be equal to its Laurent series on this domain. And the Laurent series is in fact made up of two separate series. The first one, which includes all the positive powers of C minus C naught, is called the analytic part, since this part will always be analytic, while the second one contains all the negative powers of C minus C naught, and is called the principal part. And the coefficients in the Laurent series can be determined by using this formula here. And here C is a closed curve inside the annulus surrounding C naught, but you don't really have to remember this formula, since we never really use it. Instead, we manipulate known geometric series to determine the coefficients, just like we did in the case with Taylor series. But what is an Annulus domain? An Annulus domain looks something like this. It is all the C values which lies between two circles. The inner circle is determined by the radius R1, while the second circle is determined by radius R2. And this is a typical Annulus domain. Looks pretty much like a donut, right? But an Annulus domain doesn't need to look like this. We can have one case where R1 is equal to 0. Then the domain contains all the C values inside the circle R2 except C naught. But we can also have that R2 is equal to infinity. Then the domain would be all the C values outside the circle R1. But we can also have these two cases at the same time. And then the domain would look something like this, which means that the domain would include all the C values on the whole plane except C naught. And by using this Annulus domain, we're able to capture isolated singularities. And that is why Laurent series, unlike Taylor series, still works if the point we are expanding about, C naught, is an isolated singularity. And some other good things to know is that the coefficient A minus 1 is called the residue of a function f at c is equal to c naught. And this residue will be really useful later on in the course, when we are starting to do contour integrations. And note that if we find that a function is analytic on the whole disk, then all the coefficients for the negative powers of c minus c naught will be equal to 0. And that means that the Laurent series is going to be reduced to a Taylor series. And this comes from the fact that the only thing that separates a Taylor series and a Laurent series is that a Laurent series also contains this principal part. And the last thing I would like to touch on is that these two parts of a Laurent series converges on different places in the complex plane. The analytic part converges for all C values inside the big circle R2, while the principal part only converges for C values outside the smaller circle, R1. And that is why the sum of these two series, which makes up our Laurent series, will only be valid for C values in between these two circles. Let's continue by doing some examples. So here I would like us to determine all possible Laurent series for each function here below. And we can do that by using geometric series, because we know that the Laurent series for the function f around some point C naught should look something like this. And we can get something that looks pretty much exactly like that by using these two geometric series here above. And here you can also note that the second of these two geometric series is in fact only a special case of a first series, since if you insert 1 divided by w as the w in the first series, you will get the second one. So if we now, for some constant b, insert b divided by c minus c naught as our 1 divided by w in the second geometric series, we get the following. And this thing will only be valid if the absolute value of b is smaller than the absolute value of c minus c naught. And if we now, for some constant c, insert c times c minus c naught as our w in the first geometric series, we get the following. And this thing will only be valid if the absolute value of c minus c naught is smaller than 1 divided by the absolute value of c. And here we can see that if we take the sum of these two series, we get something that looks pretty much exactly the same as our Laurent series. and the sum will only be valid inside some annulus determined by our coefficients b and c. So in short, I'm saying that if we use these two geometric series and choose our constants b and c smart, we will be able to create whatever Laurent series we would like. So let's continue with our first example. And the easiest way to determine all possible Laurent series is to mark all the important points on a graph. So we know that we are expanding about the point c is equal to 0. And we also know that the function has a pole at c is equal to 2. And that means that we can create two separate domains. One inside the circle and one outside of it. And each of these two domains will have their own Laurent series. For the first domain, we would like to use the first geometric series, since the series must be valid inside the circle. So we can start by factoring out a minus 1 to switch places on the numbers in the denominator. And then we can continue by factoring out a half to create a 1 in the denominator. And now we can use our first geometric series with w is equal to c and c is equal to a half, which will give us the following. And by moving 1 divided by 2 from the outside to the inside of the sum, we get our final expression. And this thing will only be valid if the absolute value of c is less than 1 divided by 1 half, which is the same as saying that the absolute value of c must be less than 2, which is exactly what we wanted. For the next domain, we would like to use the second geometric series, since the series must be valid outside of a circle. And to do that, we have to make our function look a little bit more like the function in the formula. If we start by factoring out 1 divided by c, we get the following. And now we can actually use the second geometric series with w is equal to c and b is equal to 2. And this expression can be simplified to the following by factoring in 1 divided by c. But if you remember, the principal part, which this thing corresponds to, should start at n is equal to 1 and not n is equal to 0. And we can easily do that by using this neat trick. Let's say that we change the variables. Let's say that k is equal to n plus 1. Then the sum would go from k is equal to 1 to infinity, and the expression inside would be 2 raised to the power of k minus 1 divided by c raised to the power of k. And now the trick is that k is only a name for a variable, and we can choose whatever name we would like. So I can rename it now to n, and we get exactly what we like to have. And this sum will only be valid if the absolute value of c is bigger than 2, which is exactly what we wanted. In our next problem, we will have the same function, but we are expanding about a different point. This time we're expanding about c is equal to 1, which means that we will get to different domains when we mark the important points. And for the first domain, we would like to use the first geometric series again. But this time, we would like to have that w is equal to c minus 1, since we are expanding about the point c is equal to 1 this time. And we can do that by breaking up our minus 2 in the denominator to minus 1 minus 1. And then we can just factor out the minus 1 to switch places on the terms in the denominator. And now we can once again use our first geometric series with w is equal to c minus 1, and the constant c is equal to 1. This gives us a series which is valid inside the right domain. And for our next domain, we would like to rewrite the expression on the form of a second geometric series. But since we still would like our w to be equal to c minus 1, we can start exactly the same as before. And by now factoring out 1 divided by c minus 1, we can once again use our geometric series. And in this case, we have that w is equal to c minus 1, and our constant b is going to be equal to 1. So that means that we get the following expression. And this expression can be simplified as the following. And to get it to start from n is equal to 1 instead of 0, we just have to decrease all the n inside the sum by 1, since we are raising our starting point by 1. And this sum will be valid outside of a circle, like we wanted. For our last example, we start by marking the important points, which are the point of expansion, c is equal to 0, and the poles for a function, which are 1 and 2. And here we can see that we can create 3 different regions. One inside the smaller circle, one between the two circles, and one outside of a big circle. So in all cases where you don't really see how you can use the geometric series right away, I recommend you to always start by rewriting the expression with the help of partial fraction expansion, so that you can determine the Laurent series by observing each of these two terms one at a time. For a first domain, we already determined earlier that 1 divided by c minus 2 is equal to the following. And since this is valid for c values inside the circle with radius 2, we know that it will also work in our domain here. And for our second term, 1 divided by c minus 1, we can rewrite it with the help of the first geometric series by factoring out minus 1, and then by using the first geometric series, we get the following expression. And if we now add these two terms together again, we get that the function's Laurent series is equal to the following. And since the sums start at the same points, we can just add them together and get the following results, which will be valid if the absolute value of c is less than 1. Since this is the only place in the complex plane where both of these two series are valid at the same time. So, until now, the Laurent series we have determined have only contained either the analytic part or the principal part. But in this second region here, we will get them both at the same time. And the trick is to let one of these two terms up here be equal to the principal part, while letting the other term be equal to the analytic part. And which one to choose to what comes from experience. But in most cases you will see that one way is absolutely more easy than another. Like in this case here, we can still use that 1 divided by c minus 2 is equal to the following. So this term can correspond to the analytic part we are searching for. And if we now try to rewrite our second term, so that corresponds to our principal part, we are all done. So, 1 divided by c minus 1 can be rewritten as the following by factoring out 1 divided by c. And if we now use our second geometric series, we get the following. And by simplifying this expression a bit, we see here that we have managed to find a principal part for a Laurent series. So, if we just add these two parts together, we get something that is valid inside these two circles, which is exactly what we wanted. For the last domain, we know that 1 divided by c minus 2 from earlier is equal to the following, and we can still use this expression for this bit here. So the only thing we really have to do is to determine the Laurent series for 1 divided by c minus 1 that is valid in this domain. But we have actually already done that. We did that in the last example. So we already know that this thing is going to be equal to the following. And if we just add these two results together, we get that the Laurent series for the function f is going to be equal to this thing here. Which only is valid if the absolute value of c is bigger than 2. Thanks for watching.